scoreboard sponsor presented by Faith Regional Physician Services. When hard work hits you hard, have faith. 12-8, Stanton leads it over EMF as we're ready to start the second quarter with Stanton on a third and about 8 yards inside their own 20 at their 18-yard line, and they're lined up close to that right hash. See what they go for here. They've been running the ball a lot, but they have passed once. Yeah, and that one time that they pass was a touchdown pass.
Well, they can throw if they need to. I know Stanton likes to keep the ball on the ground, but they have options in the air if they do want to throw. And one of those is Becker Pullman out of the backfield. They like to get him the ball easily, too.
Well, Wilkie's lined up under center, man in motion. Wilkie's going to try to run it to the right side. He gets the edge, but he's knocked out of bounds at the 23-yard line, which is 3 yards short of the line again. There is a flag on the play, and this looks like it's in the vicinity of holding on Stanton. Let's see what the call is here. Yeah. I think it is going to be holding. So it is. So both teams, one penalty in this game so far. Well, actually, two penalties for Stanton. They did have a kick out of bounds, but one holding penalty for each team, which is really costly.
Yeah, and as Wilkie was trying to get on the outside there, yeah, you can just see that hold on the interior. I think that might have been Kiefer Furnow, who just got his hands a little bit on the outside of the jersey, which can be difficult to do whenever you're on running those stretch plays outside.
I just wanted to mention as well, Brecken Schluter has had a great game running. Well, he has been involved in a lot of defensive plays. He just pushed Wilkie out of bounds. If that wasn't a hold, it would have been fourth down. So he's there on defense and offense, really a big impact maker. Ball's now at the 9-yard line, 3rd and 16, and looks like we'll get a false start here. It looks like this one is going to be on Jordan Clausen, who was lined up in the backfield next to Wilkie. He went early on that. So they're going to get backed up even further, and they're almost going to be at their own in their own end zone practically. I mean, they have their backs deep all the way back at the 4-yard line. It's going to be 3rd and 20. This is not going to be easy for Stanton.
No, you got a ways to go now. So now you're really thinking Stanton is going to be airing the ball out here, which you got to be smart about if you're Wilkie too.
Man in motion once again is Clausen. Wilkie to run it. He's got a lot of room. Wilkie going from the near side to the far side. He's across the 20, dives forward to the 21, which is a pickup of about 16 or so. So it's going to be a 4th down and 4 coming up here for Stanton. Do they pull the trigger? Do they go for this? Because that is a big pickup right there.
Well,
It was a 3rd and so long, and Wilkie still had so much space to run.
Incredible runs. Spencer Ebersbacher got right in there. Almost nobody blocked him. And Wilkie, all he had to do was step up and just see green grass in front of him. Tried to cut that back out to the outside and not able to get the first, but makes it 4th and short.
And they're going to go for this, and I think Stanton's going to want to use a timeout before they snap this ball. Our timeout sponsored by Stanton Telecom. Save when you bundle broadband internet and Stack TV, the perfect combination of high-speed internet and fiber TV packages. We'll be back after this 30-second break on Old Red 99.5 and 94.
Now it was turning.
12-8, Stanton leading it over EMF, our scoreboard sponsor, presented by Faith Regional Physician Services. When hard work hits you hard, have faith. But what a run by Barrett Wilkie. Two penalties, one hold, and one false start. Backed up Stanton to their own 5. It was 3rd and 20, and Wilkie picked up 16 yards on a design quarterback run. And now they're going to go for it, it seems, on 4th down and 4 from the 21-yard line of their own territory. So the Mustangs taking a risk here. See if the risk pays off or if EMF is going to get some incredible field position. Actually, they're going to pooch this one. They looked like they're going to go for it, but they're going to kick this one. Nobody's back for EMF to return it. It bounces inside the 20 and will eventually die down all the way at the 11-yard line. Another great punt by both of these teams. We've already seen a great one from EMF. They pin Stanton down at their own 5-yard line, and this one's going to pin EMF down at the... They're actually going to mark this at the 12, so... But, yeah, I mean, both of these teams not having to punt too much this year, but I mean, when you're in a state championship game, the defenses are kind of different.
One of the things I love about this EMF Bobcat team is they started off the season against Clarkson Lee, who is the defending state champion, and beat them by 20 points. Then you had to go play them, then lost to Sandy Creek by 2, but came back and ended up making a great run toward the end of the season.
Under center is Tyler Duke, gives it to Brecken Schluter. He's got the edge on the far sideline, gets wrapped up and knocked out of bounds by Jordan Clausen. But he gets across the 15-yard line and gets all the way to the 18. So nice pickup there. It'll be a 2nd and 5 here. By the way, fun fact, I'm talking about how these teams haven't punted too much this year. That was only punt number 11 on the season for EMF.
Wow.
Yeah, they haven't punted much, but
offense is the offense is good.
Yep.
You know, you want to keep it on the field as much as possible.
Well, Dew is under center. Once again on second down and 5 from inside the 20, Schluter gets the carry over on that right side of the O-line, gets wrapped up and brought down, but that looks like it's a gain of 5 and enough for the first down to move the chains. And now Ren Brown of Stanton is down. And he is one of their impact makers on defense. You hate to see this. And not only because, yeah, you get injured, but, like, it's the state championship. You want all these players to get a chance to play. They've worked so hard for this. So we're going to take a quick break. Ren Brown is down. We will take a 60-second break on Ole Red 99.5 and 94 Rock. Our dual broadcast on 94 Rock and Ole Red 99.5. 12-8, Stanton leading it over EMF, presented by Faith Regional Physician Services. When hard work hits you hard, have faith. We missed a play, but that's okay. It was a tip pass at the line of scrimmage, and you know what? EMF was going for the deep shot on that play. So they might take a deep shot once again here. We'll see. It's second down and 10 after the incompletion. As we're going to get a handoff here to Brecken. Schluter finds a lane. There goes Schluter. There's nobody with him as he's across the 20, across the 10 on the far sideline, and Schluter's in for 6. Brecken Schluter, as Stanton sent the pressure, gets in for 6. And there was nobody within 10 yards of him by the time he crossed that goal line. And like I said, Stanton sends blitz, but Schluter ends up getting a 58-yard rushing touchdown. And a big, big play. And when you send blitz, that's the risk you take. If you get a good block and you find the hole, you can break free. And Schluter did exactly that. And nobody from Stanton on that defense could keep up with him. So EMF strikes again. And it's 14-12 EMF in this back-and-forth affair at Memorial Stadium. I think there's just something about playing in the stadium in high school that just makes these teams different. Because these teams are just giving it their all right now and making it for a very entertaining game. Now EMF is going to go for 2. They're 1-for-1 today on 2-point conversions. Tyler Dew to pass as he rolls to his right, and he goes to the end zone. It's up for grabs. It's tipped, and it's deflected and incomplete. So Stanton does a good job to apply the pressure there, and the pass is incomplete. Intended there for Spencer Ebersbacher, who's been on defense, but tries to get himself involved in offense as well. We will be right back after this 30-second break on Ole Red 99.5 and 94 Rock. The score, EMF 14, Stanton 12, presented by Faith Regional Physician Services. When hard work hits you hard, have faith. We'll be right back. Wow. Welcome back to Memorial Stadium. And although it is rainy and cloudy today, what a game we've had in our hands so far, Kalen. What are some of your thoughts about what's happened in this game so far?
Well, the run game is lethal, especially for both teams, but recently it's been EMF. And really, we talk about Brecken Schluter. I mean, he's the guy who's been able to get it done the entire game so far. He's gotten the ball the majority of the time, and I don't see any way that they're going to stop giving the ball to Brecken Schluter.
Well, on the return, it's a short 4-yard return by Stanton. They didn't call a fair catch this time, and getting in there to make the tackle was Truman Milton, who's just a freshman, but he comes in on that special teams unit and makes a nice tackle in the state championship. So, I mean, you love to see all the guys play, but when you got freshmen out there playing,
that's impressive.
There's just something different, because when I was a freshman, I was
you weren't the star.
I was 4 foot nothing, 90 pounds. It was a rough time for me.
Kyle, I feel like you'd be the star of either of these teams out
maybe
there.
Maybe when I was dreaming and then my alarm went off. But hey, you can always dream, right? You can play some Madden. So now we will see what Stanton can do. Trailing by 2 as Barrett Wilkie under center. And he'll fake the handoff. Wilkie to pass. Goes deep over the middle of the field. He's got a man there. It's caught. It is caught by Mitchell Hupp, who already has a receiving touchdown. And now he's inside the 25, down to the 24-yard line. What a play by Stanton. They go play action. They take a deep shot with their quarterback, Wilkie. And once again, Mitchell Hupp, the senior, by the way, 6'2", so it's hard to guard him in the first place. But they make a big, big play. 30 yards right there on the pass.
My goodness. I mean, Mitchell Hupp, he's a big target, able to get all the way up and beat his defender, mossing him for the huge catch.
Wilkie on a quarterback sneak, and they're able to pick up 4 yards to the 20. Schluter once again in there on the tackle. He's just been all over the place tonight.
Yeah, great runner offensively, but a great defender, too. I mean, it's one of those things where you say, is he a better offensive player or a defensive player? I don't think you can make an argument. I think you just say, let's just watch this kid play football and see how dominant he can be.
Oh, yeah, and Jacob Weber was in there, too, on the tackle. Once again, Wilkie's under center, which we will see often today with Stanton. And he's going to run it again. Design quarterback run, but Schluter's in there again, makes the tackle. So it does Ebersbacher, as well as Draven Payne. No gain on the play. I think they actually might give him a yard on this. So it's going to be third down and five at the 19-yard line here for Stanton. Ball almost on that left hash over there.
And plenty of time here in the second quarter as well. Just over 9 minutes to play. And only a 14-12 ball game, but EMF with a chance to make a big stand defensively. Stanton, although, trying to pick up this first down on third down and see if they can get in the end zone and retake that lead.
You got to think you don't have to pick up the first down here. You can go for it on fourth down. This is definitely four down territory. Design run over the right side, and what a tackle. Nowhere to go, and getting in there and making the play is Brecken Schluter. I almost don't even have to say his name. Everybody knows it's him already.
He's got
a loss of three.
A great nose for the football, Brecken Schluter, and making this fourth and long from the 22. It's a big play for Stanton if they want to pick up this first down.
They're definitely going to go for it here with Barrett Wilkie lined up in the shotgun now. Three receivers to his left and none to his right. Wilkie steps back. They send blitz. Wilkie gets it off. It's up for grabs. It's caught by Mitchell Hupp, but he gets wrapped up and brought down over on the far side of the field, 3 yards short of the line to gain. So EMF holds, and if you can believe it, the Bobcats are going to take a two-point lead and get the ball back as well. What a big play. This EMF team really, really has come to play today. And you know what the crazy thing about that play was? Barrett Wilkie, the ball slipped out of his hands.
Well,
and that is going to be a big part of the game today because it was raining earlier.
And Wilkie, though, he pump faked at first because of the screen. Hupp wasn't ready. The blocks weren't set up. And then who comes in? Jacob Weber blows up a block and then makes the tackle short of the sticks. Great play.
Tyler Dew under center. And they're going to give it to their fullback instead this time. And it's the big man, Mikey Bartu, the junior, who is the second leading rusher on this team this season for EMF. This season, Bartu with 609 yards. If it was any indication, Brecken Schluter has over 1,100 more rushing yards than Bartu, and Bartu is the second leading rusher on this team. So Schluter has had a great year running the ball.
He's the main man. Our second quarter today brought to you by Davis and Kastmeyer Chiropractic. For the best in chiropractic care for all ages, visit Davis and Kastmeyer Chiropractic in Norfolk.
Second and six, and Schluter went to the right a little bit, but cut back up to the middle and ends up picking up about 6 yards. They might move the chains here, or it might just be short. We'll see. He's out to the 26, and they will move the chains. And it's going to be first down EMF.
Bobcats.
So Schluter can run it really, really well, but if you need him, Bartu can do it too. And honestly, we've seen Dew be able to run it as well. So they have three guys back there. And once again, they have three options here to run the ball, and they'll give it to Bartu, who powers up the middle, and then he got slammed down by Becker Pullman. Almost suplexed on that play. What a tackle. Second down and eight, and I see your face over there. You're shocked to see that, but hey, it's a big game. You gotta let out all your energy.
Yeah, I mean, Pullman, great tackle, first of all. Made a great stick right away. And I think if he lifted him up a couple more, he basically did suplex.
That's some serious leg strength right there.
Tackle.
To be able to stop him right in his tracks and almost pick him up and throw him to the turf. So second down and seven at the 39-yard line for EMF. Dew's under center. They'll give it to Bartu running to the far sideline. Bartu banged out of bounds at the 41-yard line. And it's going to be third down and about four here, or five, for the Bobcats, who are, I mean, going up by two scores in a game like this is a huge deal, especially in the first half when you're just trying to kind of set the tempo for the game and set the tone.
And I think it's big, too, just to imagine. I mean, a lot of this game is going to be four-play territory almost all the time. You can set up a third and short, pick up a couple more yards, and make it fourth and short if you need to.
See if they do that here. Third down and five, and they'll give it to Schluter. There goes Schluter. He dives on the far sideline for the first down as he gets out to about midfield, and see if they give it to him. He's at the 35 right now in Stanton territory. Will they give him the first down? No. They mark it a yard short. So let's see. EMF, you know they're going to go for it here on fourth down and one. But good Yeah, the EMF fans don't like it.
Yeah, he
reached. They think that he dove and was able to get it.
He reached for the pylon, and I just didn't. Yeah, I didn't see a great angle to see where if the ball was there before his knee was down. That's kind of the big thing.
Well, they're going to go for this, and we get a whistle from the far side official. I think EMF's crowd has done enough to warrant a review here from the referees.
And it will.
And they are going to review it. This game is brought to you by Farmers and Merchants Bank of Milligan, member FDIC, Farmers Union Co-op and Friend, Citizen State Bank, member FDIC, Horizontal Boring and Tunneling Company of Exeter, Milligan Insurance Company, Crete Area Medical Center, Wilburn Fund Medical Clinics, Smith Auto in Pawnee City. Learn more at smithautone.com. And Friend Fertilizer, your Ranky dealer and friend. We thank all of our sponsors for helping us out and allowing us to bring you the state championship game. We will be right back after this 30-second break on Old Red 99.5 and 94 Rock. All 6:28 to play in the second quarter, and it's 14-12, EMF leading it over Stanton, presented by Faith Regional Physician Services. When hard work hits you hard, have faith. EMF with the ball, fourth down and one right now, but referees are reviewing the spot of the ball because Breckenschluter, on a run to the far sideline, dove for the pylon to try to get the first down. It does not look like he stepped out of bounds. Ooh. It looked like he got it.
I think he did.
Which is why the EMF fans were so upset.
Well, he reached over. He was charging toward that first down marker and just kind of reached that ball over the defender.
You know what? You see a different angle, and his foot was out of bounds, slid out of bounds before he could dive. So
wow.
He's still going to be a yard short here. But you can't blame the EMF fans. From here, it looked like he dove and got it. But that far side official was on top of things. And you know what? This actually might even be a fourth and two. They might even move him back a yard because it looked like his foot slid out of bounds before he even got the ball forward. But we'll see. This is definitely going to be a fourth down, though, with 6:28 to play in the second.
So it just kind of depends on where that spot is at, where they're able to spot this. And that's so tough, too, because really had a really nice look at it, trying to dive for the first down marker. Schluter just able to reach that ball over.
So the EMF fans don't like it, but also they can't see the replay like we can. And that replay was pretty evident. They have a beautiful camera angle on the far sideline that perfectly showed what happened on that play. So the call is fourth down. It'll be fourth and one, but to nobody's surprise, they're going to go for it. EMF trying to keep this drive alive for Stanton. Can they stop the Bobcats in their tracks? So two backs here with two under center, and they might have gotten Stanton to jump.
They
might have. Coming across was Ren Brown. He's standing in the backfield right now of EMF before the play even got snapped, and they're going to get a first down here. It's going to be a neutral zone infraction.
What a call. What a call from Pfeiffer and Kalen to say, hey, we know we're going to try to go get this, but let's make it on two. Let's make the defense jump. They knew that Stanton was kind of on their heels, mm-hmm. ready just to pounce, if you will. And a great job coaching with the hard count. I thought they were going to go right for it, but the hard count works and gets the first down for the Bobcats.
Well, Draven Payne checked into the game for EMF. He's a receiver. Let's see if they take a shot here. They don't have anybody out wide. They're going to play action, though. They might take a shot. Dew's back, spins, and throws it to the near or to the far sideline. Breckenschluter makes the catch, and he's able to get inside the 35. And then he's able to pick up 6 yards. What a play by Dew. You bring out one of your wideouts in Draven Payne. It seemed like they were going to take a shot, and they were trying to, but nice play by Tyler Dew to elude the tackle in the backfield and dump it out to Schluter, who was in the flat.
It was really good pocket awareness by Dew as Ren Brown got right through there, had a chance to make a stop, maybe even a sack on Tyler Dew, but he did a really nice job with the pocket awareness and being able to find his safety valve.
Same formation here for EMF on second down and three. And Dew is going to take the snap, hand it off to Schluter, powers his way forward. He's inside the 30, down to the 29, which is a four-yard gain and a first down for the Bobcats. So they are really not only running the clock on this drive, and there's 5.5 minutes to play in the first half, but they're probably wearing out the Stanton defense like crazy right now.
Yeah, really just keeping them on their heels. EMF doing a great job of keeping the football on the ground. And Stanton, they have a very good defense, but they've been out on the field for quite some time now.
Well, Draven Payne back in the game again, but he's lined up in the slot. They're going to hand off to their big man. There goes Bartu right up the middle. And it was a fullback run and a gain of about 4 yards down to the 26-yard line. But whenever they bring Payne in, you always got to be ready for a pass play because Payne is good trying to go deep, and they can run that play action. It has fooled teams before, and they did that really, really well in the game that we covered on Ole Red against Thayer Central. They ran play action, and Thayer Central just could not figure out if it was play action or if it was a run play. And it would work very often. Due gives it to Schluter, trying to get to the edge on the right side, but he gets nowhere, and he is brought down on the play by Mitchell Hupp. So he has a receiving touchdown and now has a TFL as well.
What a tackle. What Mitchell Hupp did is he got on right through, wrapped his arms. He's got such a good length around Schluter, and just didn't let go, yep. Anchored his body down to the turf.
That is what you have to do against Schluter. He's so good at breaking tackles. But a great job by Hupp to wrap him up. And that's that senior experience right there as well from Hupp. So now it's third and down and about five. Then you get down to the 20. They're at the 26. Here's a flip out to Schluter on the left side. And they pitch it to him. And he runs into his own man but dives forward. He'll be marked down, though, at about the 20 or 21-yard line. We'll see which one it is because that it makes a big difference. He just ran into his own lineman on that play and still was able to dive forward and nearly move the chains. So it's going to be a fourth and inches once again here, and I mean it when I say inches. To get the first down, you need to get down to the 20. And I kid you not, that ball is on the 20. I don't know if you can see that, Kalen, but that ball is almost as close as you can get. I mean, literally centimeters away from the first down marker. But, hey, football is a game of inches. Let's see if Stanton can stop him. Duke gives it to Schluter, trying to power forward on the left side, and he gets there. And he's able to pick up 3 yards inside the 20, down to the 17. Schluter is just over-reliable right now for EMF. You can always count on him when you give him the ball, and you can always count on him to be able to pick up that first down.
Yeah, very talented running back, not only when he runs, but he's got good vision, too, and that helps a lot for EMF. We mentioned this earlier, too, wasting that clock. Now under 3 minutes, and the Bobcats holding a 14-12 lead over the Mustangs on the Faith Regional Physician Services scoreboard.
Bartu in the backfield with Schluter, and they're going to give it to Schluter, who is the second back. He powers forward right up the middle and gets about 3 or so yards down to the 14-yard line. A nice tackle again by Hupp, Mitchell Hupp. But like you said, you said it very well, Kalen. I mean, got 2.5 minutes to go. Even if Stanton gets the ball back, whether EMF scores or whether they turn it over or whatever happens, they're not going to have much time to really do anything before halftime.
And we got to keep in mind that the Bobcats get the ball to start the third quarter. That's huge.
Let's see. A score here would be huge as well. But Duke fumbles the snap. Who jumped on it first? It looked like it might have been Schluter. The snap went right through the legs of Duke. I think he thought he had the ball, and Schluter had the awareness to jump on that ball in the backfield before any Stanton Mustang was able to jump on it. Third down and 9 here. A big loss on that play. Of about 4 or so yards. We'll see here if Stanton starts to call their timeouts because they haven't called one yet. At least in this part of the game. They've already called one here in the first half. They have 2 remaining. They're not going to use one. 1:40 to go. 3rd down and 9. They're going to pitch it outside on the near sideline. Over on the left side, it's Schluter, and he gets wrapped up out of bounds at about the 11-yard line, which is 4 yards short of the line to game.
Now this is huge. You're at the 11-yard line for EMF, leading by 2 with only a minute 32 to play. What is the play you drop? You got to pick up this first down, potentially to increase your lead and keep your drive going. Otherwise, for Stanton, this is potentially the biggest stop of the game, at least this far. You're down by 2 points. You know that that EMF gets the ball back at the third quarter. Mustangs need a huge stop here on 4th and short.
Well, I think you give it to Schluter, but also they got 3 wideouts, and one of them is Draven Payne. Will they pass it? We get a whistle from the far side official. Stanton wants to talk this one over. They'll use their second timeout of the half with 1 remaining. We will take a 30-second break and be right back on Ole Red 99.5 and 94 Rock.
On the Faith Regional Physician Services scoreboard, when hard work hits you hard, have Faith. EMF 14, Stanton 12. And this timeout from Stanton is brought to you by Stanton Telecom. Save when you bundle broadband internet and Stack TV, the perfect combination of high-speed internet and fiber TV packages.
14-12 EMF with the lead. This might be one of the biggest plays of the first half so far. Fourth down and four coming up here for the Bobcats. And you said it very well before the break. A score here would do a lot of good for EMF. And they get the ball to begin the second half. Ball at the 11. Dew's empty. Man in motion is Schluter from the near side of the far side. Dew to pass. Now he gets pressured, escapes the pressure. He's going to run it on the near sideline, and he gets tripped up and brought down a yard short at the 8-yard line. What a tackle by Becker Pullman.
I mean,
I think they're going to mark him short. Yeah, they're marking him down at the 9. You need to get to the 8.
Yeah, Stanton just made a huge stop, and I want to give credit to EMF. The play design was perfect. You had Brecken Schluter, who was running from the near side of the field to the far side, ran an out route, and Barrett Wilkie, who was on him man-to-man defense, got caught up with the blockers. Wide open, Tyler Dew couldn't get the ball off because of the pressure and had to run it. What a tackle from Pullman, and Stanton has the football with 1:25 to play.
Yeah, just 1 yard short of the line to gain, and EMF, I'm sure they'll be looking back at that and wishing that they could have scored. Here's a direct snap now to Pullman, though. He runs to the left side, and he gets brought down after a 1 yard gain out to about the 11-yard line. Nice run there by Pullman. One timeout left for Stanton, two for EMF. Second down and about 8 here with 1:10 to play in the first half. 14-12. Bobcats leading it over the Mustangs. By the way, EMF 11-1 this season, and their only loss was a really close one, 64-62 to Sandy Creek, and Stanton is unbeaten. 12-0 for the second straight regular season. There's a flip. It looks like a trick play, and Stanton's going to get big yardage from this as they get across the 20-yard line to the 24. It looked like it was going to be a handoff to Pullman. Instead, they go the other way to Clausen and is able to pick up the first down for Stanton. Trick plays. You got to bring them out now.
All the stops. Great reverse and now going quickly.
Yeah, they're going quick here. Deep shot down the near sideline for Wilkie. He's got a man there. It's caught inside the 20, and no one's going to catch Jordan Clausen. He's in for the touchdown.
Oh, my goodness. Giving chase defensively, Mikey Bartu kind of got caught up there looking for the ball, and Clausen just slid right under it. It bobbled in his hands, held on for the touchdown. Stanton takes the lead.
56-yard passing touchdown by Wilkie. Did we expect that? But Stanton, their running game has struggled a little bit, and they go with the passing, their second passing touchdown of the game. They'll go for two. They are 0-for-2 today, though, on two-point conversions. They tried running it both times. Will they decide to pass it? 36 seconds to go in the first half. What a play by Clausen to be able to not only have awareness to make sure he doesn't step out of bounds, but to go over the shoulder and make the catch as Bartu was closing in on the pressure. And not only that, but what a throw by Wilkie. Stanton showing off the big guns.
I mean, it was a perfect
18-14.
Throw.
It really was a perfect throw. And I mean, he just lobbed it up there. It was one-on-one coverage, and Wilkie just lobbed it up, and Clausen won the battle.
Bartu might have gotten a finger on that, but Clausen reels it in, 56 yards, and now a timeout from Stanton.
Yep.
Brought to you by Stanton Telecom. Save when you bundle broadband internet and Stack TV, the perfect combination of high-speed internet and fiber TV packages. So on the Faith Regional Physician Services scoreboard, when hard work hits you hard, have faith. Right now it's Stanton 18, EMF 14, but a two-point conversion.
Yep, they're going to go for two with Wilkie under center and Pullman in the backfield. Can they get this two-point conversion? They flip it out to Pullman. He's going to pass it back to Wilkie to the far sideline. Wilkie has blocks, and he is in for the two-point conversion. They once again go with trickery, and it works. They're now 1-for-3 today on two-point conversions, and Stanton takes a 20-14 lead over EMF late in the first half. We will be right back after this 30-second break on Ole Red 99.5 and 94 Rock. What a game. 20-14 Stanton leading over EMF, presented by Faith Regional Physician Services. When hard work hits you hard, have faith. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska. 20-14 Stanton leading it over EMF. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, for all of you listening at home, this is a simulcast between 94 Rock and Ole Red 99.5. Thank you all for joining us in this great game. I mean, this was a game that we knew was going to be close. EMF, despite being a 7 seed, despite being 11-1, they had to go through some really good teams in the playoffs to get to where they are today. And Stanton, they're unbeaten for a reason. They're the 1 seed, and Stanton is able to get a big over 50-yard touchdown pass. Barrett Wilkie delivering it to the junior, Jordan Clausen. And by the way, we were able to see that replay, and it was really close, but Bartu did not get a fingertip on that throw. It was just a really good catch there from Clausen. And they are currently reviewing the spot of where this ball is on the two-point conversion. They're reviewing if Wilkie was even able to get in. Oh, you know what? You know what? He came up a yard short because the ball was in his left arm, and he got bumped by Schluter and forced him to go the other way. And when he landed in the end zone, his whole body landed in the end zone, Kalen, but not the ball in his left arm.
You talk about,
I think this is going to come back.
Again, two-point conversions being so big. Because if this stands, then it's a six-point lead for Stanton. If not, it's only a four-point lead. 36 seconds to play. Here is the call.
Let's see. Yep, so they say he was down. And I kid you not, ladies and gentlemen, he was down, I mean, centimeters short of the goal line. And that is an amazing tackle by Schluter to be able to force him out of the end zone. It looked like he was in for certain. I mean, he had the blocking, he had the speed, and Schluter makes another great play on defense, but that play cannot be overshadowed by a great touchdown pass from Wilkie, delivering it to Jordan Clausen for 6, but once again, failing on a two-point conversion. 0-for-3 today, Stanton, on two-point conversions. And 18-14 seems a lot nicer for EMF right now than 20-14.
I mean, and Stanton's got to be happy. They were still able to score, yep, and they did it fast.
But oh, yeah.
That two-point conversion is just so big. And it might not seem like it right now, but toward the end of the game, we see a lot of eight-man games come down to 2 points, 4 points, 6 points.
See if EMF's going to return this, and they are. It's going to be Bartu. He's up the near sideline. He's across the 30-yard line and knocked out of bounds at the 32, so good starting field position for EMF. By the way, Kalen, wanted to mention, saw this on the replay, but on that touchdown pass, the reason why Clausen was able to get some space and get one-on-one, EMF was not ready for the play to snap. They were still looking to their sideline for the play call, and Stanton went quickly, snapped the ball. EMF wasn't ready, and they took a deep shot, which is a really good play, not only by Wilkie in the quarterback position, but also Coach Stoddard as well, to call that so quickly and have that play ready.
Yeah, they did the hurry-up offense, which worked out well.
EMF now, they might have to throw it. Here goes Schluter, option play, flipping it out to Draven Payne on the far sideline. Payne is across the 35, and he's down to the 38-yard line. Good pickup of about 6 yards. He's almost at midfield, and EMF's going to call their second timeout of the half. They have one remaining after this with 19 seconds to go in the first half. We'll keep it here on 94 Rockin' Ole Red 99.5. Thank you to everybody listening at home, as well as everybody working back in the studio on board to be able to send this to commercial breaks and make this possible, and also all of our sponsors as well. But 18-14, Stanton leading it over EMF. Kalen, we're not going to have too much time to discuss this at the end of the half. We'll have a lot of time in a halftime show, but I don't know, what are some of the things that you've seen so far that kind of stand out to you, and not only on one side, but on both?
Well, I think honestly, EMF has done a tremendous job defensively. Really, Stanton has burst through a couple big plays. It really hasn't been a lot of tiny chunk plays. Every once in a while, they'll do the quarterback sneak that works really well for the Mustangs, but EMF's defense has been really good. Stanton's has made the big stops when they've needed to, though, and we'll see if the Mustangs can do it here again against the Bobcats. Only 19 seconds.
That's second down and 3. Will EMF throw the ball? Schluter's lined up in the Wildcat. He fakes the run. He throws it instead. Draven Payne makes the catch on the far sideline. He fumbled the ball out of bounds, though, and he's all the way across midfield to the Stanton 34-yard line. So really nice design play right there by EMF. Looked like Schluter was going to run it. Then he stopped on a dime and threw it instead to Draven Payne. And I told you, when Draven Payne comes out into that offense, they have a high chance of throwing the ball. He's a good receiver.
Yeah, he's got now 8 catches this year for over 90 yards and a touchdown. And I think that this is a really good spot for EMF to be in. Only 13 seconds, but you're inside Stanton territory. A big chance to maybe continue to see if you can throw this football or try the Wildcat.
Got 2 receivers to the left. Schluter in the Wildcat is going to run it. Flips it out to Bartu on that far sideline. He gets wrapped up and brought down to the 30. I think he went out of bounds, and he did. With 9 seconds to go in the first half, one timeout for EMF. Second down and six here for the Bobcats. And I don't know, what do you do here, Kalen, if you're in this situation?
Well, Becker Pullman, first of all, big tackle as well on the far sideline. Bobcats, you know, probably don't want to try a 57-yard field goal.
Nope.
So you've got 9 seconds and ball on the 30-yard line.
Yeah, I'm thinking with that timeout, you don't need to get out of bounds.
No,
you can
don't.
Go over the middle if you want.
It's got to be a short play, though.
Yep. 9 seconds to go. Schluter and the Wildcat again. They're going to give it to Bartu instead. Bartu running on the near sideline. Is he going to get out of bounds? He does at the 21-yard line with 3 seconds to go. Really good play again by EMF. They're bringing out all of the tricks, and it's working. But they don't have too much time left. They're going to have to take a shot to the end zone here.
Yeah.
EMF sees, why not? We have one timeout left. Let's call it here with 3 seconds to go in the first half.
Great play design. You had Schluter, who was he was in the shotgun right behind the center. Bartu jumped right in front of the football, take the direct snap, and had a nice gain off across the near side. Ball on the 21-yard line, and this is where Pfeiffer and Kalen can use that last timeout to talk about, hey, what play can we draw up here? Do you want to keep the ball on the ground, or do you want to let Tyler Dew air it out? He's got 8 touchdowns this year, longest play of the season, 68 yards. Obviously, a lot of that is catch and run, but he can definitely get the ball to the end zone. Maybe you just want to give one of your guys a shot.
Well, I'm thinking that they might do that, but you wouldn't count out the lateral play either. I mean, the way this team runs it, like you said, I wouldn't be surprised if they decide to run it too. But the interesting thing was that Tyler Dew was not lined up in the shotgun or under center on those last few plays. It was Brecken Schluter and the Wildcat. So they're going to bring Dew back out, though. He's in the game, along with Draven Payne, as well as Mikey Bartu, and, of course, Brecken Schluter well.
Yeah, got your athletes on the field.
Yep. See, they're going to have to go to the end zone here in Stanton. I think this is the deepest that I've seen their defense play all game. Doesn't seem like they have to worry about the short run.
Yeah, 2 down linemen for Stanton right now.
First down and 10 from the 21. Dew steps up in the pocket as they send 2. Dew going to the end zone. He's got a man there. It's up for grabs, and it's deflected away and incomplete by Barrett Wilkie. Nice defensive play, and that will end the first half. Barrett Wilkie taking off his helmet, running to the locker room. I'm sure Stanton is happy with a 4-point lead heading into halftime. What a game from Memorial Stadium in Lincoln. Stanton leading it 18-14 over EMF, presented by Faith Regional Physician Services. When hard work hits you hard, have faith. We'll take a 60-second break on Old Red 99.5 and 94 Rock, and then we will have our halftime show coming up next on Old Red 99.5 and 94 Rock. If you're